Hello and welcome to yet another update video. In a past video, I talked about an update for the LEGO Mindstorms robot inventory software, but now we got a few other updates. First, there's a new programming software for the LEGO Mindstorms EV3, or for the retail version, because the software was available for the education version for a few months now. And there has been a documentation or a roadmap for the powered-up system. That's what we will talk about in this video, but first we will talk about the EV3 software. Back when the EV3 was new, this was the original software. It had icons that you could drag around and then you could program the robot by doing that. But that software doesn't work on 64-bit systems, so that's the reason why it can't be used on current Mac systems. And that's the reason why LEGO wrote a new software, and it's scratch-based software, so we have these text blocks and we can drag them around and we can program the robot that way. And now the software is available for the retail version. It's available for macOS, for iOS, for Windows 10 and for Android. You can download it in the App Store of your choice. And then this is the software. It contains the five main models from the kit, but it lacks the additional fan models. You can download the fan model instructions on this site, but there are no pre-made projects for the fan-made robots. And by that, I mean if you select one of these robots, you have these missions, you can start them, then you get the building instructions, and then you can test what you build. And another problem is that not all of the hardware is supported. You can't use third-party sensors, and you can't use some older sensors like the NXT sensors, or the energy meter, or the temperature sensor, I think. So there are quite a few limitations on the software, but it might be enough for your purpose. And now to the roadmap. A few days ago, there were the LEGO Fan Media Days. And that's an event where recognized fan mediums, which I'm not, but other people are, can talk to LEGO people or LEGO employees, and LEGO tells some stuff about what they plan to do and stuff like that. And there's been a presentation about the powered up system, and we will cover a few of the points here. I will link the site in the description, which has all of these slides available. And first of all, there will be an update for the coding canvas, for the coding, or for the block style, for the graphical style, which is a bit problematic for me because I made a tutorial for the powered up app, but now they redo the interface, so I might have to make the tutorial again, or I will have to make parts again, or I don't know. I will have to see how I will solve that issue. Also, they will discontinue the Droid Commander app, and it should be more or less integrated into the powered up app. We will see how good that works, and I think that that will be a major point where we can see if the powered up system is actually longevity, so if we can use these things in the future. So we will see how good the models or the stuff from the Droid Commander app will be integrated into the powered up app. Also, there will be new widgets for the programming environment. There will be a new controller for electronical vehicles. And there will be a few options to adjust the design, including the backgrounds. Yeah, we will get new icons or a new design of the coding canvas. And we will get the powered up VM. And that was announced a few months ago, so this is nothing completely new. But the hubs contain microcontrollers, and these microcontrollers can be programmed. So normally you have a smartphone and then you stream the commands that you program to the hub, but it's also possible to run programs directly on the hub. Currently, it's only available with Pybricks, but there will be a solution with the Powered Up app in the future, and it's called Powered Up VM. And they wanted to start a closed test, I think in January or something like that. They didn't start yet, but it should probably start soon or sooner or later. And we will get some improvements when it comes to the usability or how easy it can be used. And there will be more documentation, some tutorials and stuff like that. And then here's also a Q&A. Again, I will link the site in the description so you can read that there. And Rising Brick mentioned that there will be an additional Powered Up device or sensor or motor or stuff like that this year. But we will see what will come out. Thanks for watching so far. See you in the next video and bye.